Hello and welcome to a new video of my Unity MMO tutorial series. And yeah, in the last lecture I showed you how to create the execute function. And yeah, today I will expand this a little bit. And we will try our first login, and yeah, we will see what we are doing then. Okay, at first I find an error, and therefore we have to go to our YukiNet and to our package parser. And in the package base, package from stream, I got an error, and in the last lectures I forgot to return the package. This was not there, and if you try then to log in, it maybe worked, but after this, if you have more function like our race package we did to come to the race response and the race request. So if we request a race, and yeah, in the next lecture we will change this one. This is, of course, yeah, we won't select a race. We will select a realm, like in Dark Age of Camelot, or in World of Warcraft, you choose the Alliance or the Horde. And because the race we will have in the character creation with Uma, and there are the races that you have, the human or an orc or stuff like this, and that's why we changed this one. Because I want to have a realm selection. Not a realm like a service in World of Warcraft, but like a faction as a Horde or Alliance. And yeah, so we have to go to the package parser and type this one. So type return package in this line in the package base. Pass package from stream. So we give the package back to the reader, and the reader can type out to the server or to the client maybe. And if we have done it, we have to build the solution, and then we have to go to the file folder and go to bin, debug, net standard, and we will copy the YukiNet, and then we have to go to our Unity, right click on assets and show in Explorer, and that will open a new window. Then we go to assets and copy this, and we have to override it. Sorry, it's in German because I'm from Germany. And yeah, so you have to override it, and then we need to go back to our Unity, and then we have to go to the assets and refresh everything. It will take a little bit, and yeah. And yeah, as you can see, the login screen and the username appeared back, and now it's fully loaded, the new version. And yeah, so if we go to our client manager, we can add this scene later, and this on enabled, because we will change it a little bit, because we need to say if we are we change the scene, we will destroy our client manager script. And yeah, if it's so, you don't have the connection in every scene, and if you don't have this one in every scene, you cannot work. So you need this. And then we have the D dot. This is this one. I get the component of our menu manager, and this will be in our scene. We have to edit here, so I create an empty and call it menu manager. Or no, we don't create a new one. We will put the script of the menu manager under the client manager, because we don't kill the client manager. And yeah, you can put everything you want. You don't want to destroy on the client manager. So and if we are done, we go to our prefabs folder and we drag and drop our client manager here, because then we can load this one out of the scene. And we have to do another thing, and another thing is you go to the client manager, and as you can see, we have the username input and the password input, and we can go to our canvas, our panel, and then we have the categories username and password, and then we go to the username and drag and drop the username input and put it on the username input, and the same with the password input. So we have the fields set, and then we can go to the login button, and I will delete this, and then you can scroll down and you can see a function on click and the list is empty. And this is the action you start if you click on the login button. So we add, click on the plus, move the client manager in it, and then we see you can start editor and runtime. If you do this one, you can click it in editor mode, but we don't want it, so we let the runtime only checked. Then we have to go to the functions, and as you can see, we have the menu manager here and the client manager, and we go to the client manager and launch our execute function, and then we can save. So we can go to the code, and every time you click on the login button, you call this function. So you start to build the connection, then you check the menu manager, you connect to the server, and here you set strings. So everything you type in the text field of the username, it will save in the username string, the same with the password. And then we create a new request packet and send it to the server, and the server says okay, everything is okay, the user is in the database, and then then the server send back the response and say yeah, it's valid or something else, everything you want to send to the client. And then we start a new menu. So in the menu manager, if you can check the race selection, you have the race selection screen, but we don't have it yet, the race selection screen, and I will do it in a Yeah, in the next lecture is it's like the same like the login screen, but now we will test it and we go back to our MMORPG 2.0 Visual Studio solution map and go to the master server, right click on it, and yeah, at first we will build the solution. So we go right click on the solution MMORPG 2.0, and as you can see there, three projects are built successful and one is up to date. It's the Yukinet we built before. And then you can right click on the master server, or you can choose here in this line the master server. I won't do it because if I want to debug something in the client, I have to choose this one because it's the Unity project file, and then we have to attach it to the Unity engine, and then your breakpoints will work. So if you want to debug something, like I can show you. We go to the client manager and I will debug our execute function. And at first I will right click on the master server and click on debug and start in a new instance. You have to do it because you cannot I need to attach it before I start the new instance. So now we debug the client. And if you go to the Explorer and then Solution Explorer, sorry, and then right click on the master server, and yeah, then you have to go to the debug and start in a new instance. And as you can see, there is a new window and we started the server successfully. And now we can go back to the Unity engine. And yeah, we can click on play. And yeah, I've saved my username before in the database with a PHP file. I will put on the server later and post it in the videos. And if you have problems, you can join my Discord server or write it down in the comments below the videos. And yeah, if you like my stuff, you can leave a like or a positive comment and join also my Discord community. And yeah, let's click on the login button. And so now we clicked on the login button, and as you can see, the debug started, and then you can choose F10 or Alt plus the star on the numpad, and or click this button, and then you can go through it step by step. And okay, no, you need to click this one step over, sorry. And if you hold down this one, you can see the client manager and the menu manager, or you can see the client connect the what is in. So is connected is true. So the server is running and you connect it, and now you can see what is typed in this username. You see deadly virus, this is my name. And yeah, if you hold on password, it's null. And if I go there's a password I've set. And yeah, if you click on continue, you stop debugging and you can do this one. And as you can see, there is an error because we don't have this this race selection yet. And yeah, you need to add go to file, build settings, and add every scene down here. But we don't have it, and we will create it in the next lecture and do some changes with the race selection. Thank you for watching and see ya.